make your wish?
It won't go.
Well, my friends are all gone and my hair is gray. I ache in the places that I used to play. And I'm crazy for love, but I'm not coming off. I'm just paying my rent every day in the Tower of Song. I said to Hank Williams, how lonely do you get? Oh, Hank Williams hasn't answered me yet, but I can hear him coughing all night long. 100 floors above me right here in the Tower of Song. Crazy voices through a window in the Tower of Song. Well, I was born like this and I had no choice. I was born with the gift of a golden voice and 27 angels from the great beyond. See, they tied me to this table right here in the Tower of Song.
So you gotta tell me about Bob.
Well, Bob, he's a rat. And once I found Bob, he was over there. And this is Bob. And Bob has a wife. Her name is
Lila.
Lila. And she got colored like Bob, and I found her over here. And she's a rock too. She's part of Bob. He's really colorful and he has curly hair. And I do not get him at all.
He makes art.
And he makes art like Bob. And he got the picture when they bought the dog and he bought this fish. Which I know nothing about it and I don't know his name, but
Fishy Fish.
Fishy Fish is his name. And all he does all day is swim around and blow bubbles.
Race in Egyptian sheets, blanketed in dark morning sky, just before dawn, I do not touch her yet. Handcuff my fingers to stillness, arch and trough my hips until treacherous Nile wraps around my thighs and tangles in her lips. I am craving her softness, her morning mist, the sheathing of my unshackled limbs. This all started with an ancient comedic ritual of meditating with the sunrise. Post a few creative liberties, I became the sun's rising, a lotus flower awaiting her morning christening. Ever since I've discovered this garden, it has rained almost every day. My fingers submit to gravity, drip down my honey torso, voyage into deep Amazonian forest. I slide in her, slide up then release. The perfume of her honey grows deeper in an air that thickens just to hold her scent. Before Aurora hits the sky, I pull out her tide like the moon. My fingers tell my tongue it must taste it. I lift them to my mouth and weaken. Eden wished she knew a garden this lush, a fruit this sweet, a love this forbidden, for up until now it was reserved only for the gods. I returned her to the one-finger grasp, the two-finger tangle, my lover's silk jowl clenched around my knuckles. She sighs, the first picture of pink into the sky that holds the image and savors her pleasure.
To the place of grander displeasurement.
There'll be no pleasure here for him. Cosmic Tormaker, you should be unhappy for a long time. Henceforth, goodbye.
And so forth.